Hello and welcome, my name is Parky and today we're playing some more Spore. Meet me back in the universe, where last time we bought pretty much everything that we could get our hands of, which was very fun, and I plan to carry on that trend today if I can. And the way we're going to be doing that is by collecting a load of spice initially, which is not always the most exciting thing, but at least it's something. Okay, so what actually is there left that we can buy up? Because I think we've got pretty much everything now. We can get an embassy, which I think would be at least interesting to see what it looked like, because obviously it's not part of the base game. It's going to increase our relationship with another empire over time, which is pretty cool. And actually, it's these little things that I really wish that they'd just thought of putting in the vanilla game. Because my god, I mean, they could have made more of the diplomatic sort of stuff in Space Stage, couldn't they? Okay, and we've also got the anti-mitter missile, which is 1 million spore bucks, so we can maybe go for that at some point too, because I think that's pretty good, if I'm not mistaken. And I think you get unlimited amounts of it, because there's no number there. Okay, now aside from that, we've got the laser, which isn't very exciting, and maybe expanding some more of these businesses, because we have yet to discover what the end game of these businesses are, which kind of bothers me slightly. So, let's go around, see if people want to buy up any of my spice, and we're probably going to take quite a while to find one, seeing as there's so many different kinds of spice, but it seems like no one really wants to buy any of them, which is a bit sad. Parky sad. It's like if you were a paperboy, right? Bear with me for a second. If you're a paperboy and you sell papers, like The Big Issue, that no one cares about. Now, The Big Issue, if you don't have it in America, I have no idea whether you do or not. I'm going to assume that you don't. Oh god, hostile UFOs. How dare you interrupt my ramble? Okay, well, I suppose we should probably go and help, seeing as they're attacking our main planet. Or is it this one? I don't really know. Oh, it is the main planet, okay. Yeah, so if you're... The Big Issue, right, is like one of these magazines, which actually is surprisingly alright if you ever buy it, but it's got a lot of stigma attached to it because it's what homeless people sell in order to make some money, which is fair enough. Oh my god, I keep forgetting how massive these things are. Okay, I haven't even got my weapons out. I'm just here as a casual observer. I've got so many weird weapons now, I don't even know which ones to use. It's not supersonic pulse, is it? I don't think so. Oh, that's it. Oh, you're welcome. I am a true hero. You're welcome. I am so good at this. I have literally one job. Oh, wow. Okay, I didn't realise we had this much blue spice. Well, we're certainly going to sell all that then. So let's now buy... Oh, a cosmic vibration vacuum. Uses the powers of the mind to extract cosmic energy from things. I don't even know what that means, but we're going to do it. And we've also got a few other things here that I could probably buy as cheaper somewhere else, but who even cares? Money seems no object in this game. So yes, Big Issue. I don't even know what I was talking about. If you're like a paperboy that was selling the Big Issue, then perhaps people wouldn't buy it from you. I can't remember what I was talking about. Anyway, we're going to place this down. Expand Void Corporation, which we haven't actually done yet. Spaceport from your friends at Void. Let me guess, another invisible building? It's going to be around here somewhere, surely. Okay, fine. Well, I have literally no idea what it does. But that's okay. So let's pick up some of this money, because money is no object. In fact, it is a lot of objects that are very important in this world. So don't ever say that. I have to disagree with the sentiment a lot of people have over money in real life. That it doesn't make you happy. Well, having no money certainly doesn't make you happy either. Nothing makes anyone happy anymore. It's not cool to be happy. What is going on with today's episode? Okay, what is this? Expand Void Corporation and get another one of those. I don't really know what the point of this is. It just seems like an endless money sink, doesn't it? Okay, fine. Have we got a monolith yet? Because I definitely want to upraise another race of alien beings. Brilliant bomb. Okay, I think it's probably in here. Oh, we did have one. Okay, well, we've probably used it once already. But that's okay. Right, what else have we got here? A mini happy ray. We'll get that out of the shop. Mind erase as well. And this is energon repair. Heals your spaceship with an energy cost. Wow, okay, I mean, there's so many tools in this now. I don't know how, if you're in, like, the height of battle, you're in the height of battle, that you'd be able to, like, click and go, oh yes, I need an energon repair, quickly, click on the third tab and there's the second one on the bottom right. Oh, that makes so much sense. Man, They really need to make a better way. I think this just generally needs a better UI in general, doesn't it? General. It's kind of like WoW. And just before any WoW people get annoyed, I know there's a lot of things you can do in WoW to negate this issue, but it's like how you've got so many skills that you can use, and you only effectively use probably like 10 of them. But you've got like a bar full of shit down in the bottom. If you're in the height of battle, how the hell are you going to find anything that you need? That's kind of how I'm feeling right now. Okay, so should we uplift one of these guys? I suppose we could do. Trawlus? Sure, Trawlus, it's your lucky day. And there's only one planet. Wow, look at this. What a lonely planet. It's like the Lonely Mountain from The Hobbit, but in planet form, maybe. Okay, let's get our bloody monolith out, and we're going to stick it right up your ass. No, in the middle of your place. I'm literally going to destroy your building with it. Oh no, it didn't work. Where did it go? Why is it flying around like that? Okay, not quite what I had planned. Why is it going into space now? Okay. Right, it's been established in the atmosphere. I don't think it's supposed to do that. The monolith will cause this planet to evolve. Come back later to see what happened. Where the hell is it? Oh, okay. Yes, of course. That makes so much sense. How do I rotate the camera? Am I being stupid? I feel like I might be. Maybe you can't. Why is it in the middle of the air? Okay, you know what? Don't worry about it. We can use harmonic vibrations. Oh yes, that's what that was. It's got mind arrays, mini happy ray. I should probably start looking at what these are, shouldn't I? Just a bomb. It's just a bomb. That's all it is. Supersonic pulse! Maybe I'll shoot this at one of these guys. Okay, what's that doing? It kind of just looks like the scanning tool, doesn't it? The first weapon in the galaxy to consist entirely of sound. It doesn't even hurt the people. Right, okay, and then we've got the mini pulse pyrolaser. Can't remember what this looks like. Oh god, okay, that's nice. And then we've got loads of other stuff. Shields. So I mean, like, if you're in the middle of a battle, you wouldn't exactly pop your shields. Be like, ah, there's not even, like, hotkeys for these tabs. Okay, so we've got the Staff of Life. I'm just trying to remember what's going on. Right, so what should we do? We should go and explore, shouldn't we? See if we can wipe out that Blue Nation as well, because they're bastards. Dirty bastards. And we're just basically waiting on everyone's trade deals to come to an end, and I believe the blue guys are over here, aren't they? Oh yes, but the blue guys are massive. God damn. Okay, we've got purple here. Not sure how big the purple empire are, but they're very happy with me. And I believe we have met them, haven't we? Yeah, I think so. Okay, have you got anything we want? You can have all my bloody whatever this is. Coriander. Oh, I'll tell you what, the purple nation, they love a good bit of coriander. Earth Sculpt, Terra Wrangler 5. Used on a planet to render its surface akin to that of Earth's. Wow, inverts the planet's surface. And Cube Sculpt. Cube Planet? Man, okay, Terra Wrangler 5 or Trader 5. Interesting, let's see what we need for that. Trader 5. Surely we must be near that. You'd think, anyway, wouldn't you? Explorer? Merchant? Oh no, it's the merchant one that I've got all of. Where is it? Ah, oh, there's so many bad... I don't know what any of them look like either. You'd think by this point in time I'd know what everything was in this game. I've played it so much that I am so pro, still not. Where the hell is it? Well, the Terra Wrangler badge is the terraforming score. So we just need to go and terraform a load of planets. Okay, well, I suppose we could do that, actually, couldn't we? So if we just go and terraform a load of stuff and maybe settle on it, that'd be cool. Okay, what's here? Oh, there's already an occupied place over here. Okay, well, we'll go for this yellow spice, just expand the empire a little bit, so let's zoom in and start using our Staff of Life, which I believe only uses energy now instead of anything else, which is kind of weird and slightly overpowered. Okay, so let's put down a colony over here, because I don't even care anymore. And this is Terra Score. Maybe we can't do that yet. Use on a planet to completely terraform it in an instant. Why can we not use this? Oh, we can. There we go. Yeah, it's just endless. It's just a recharge now, which is a bit overpowered in my mind. But there you are. Can't do anything about it. Right, so we've got this planet. I suppose we can now leave this dirty damn place. It's brown planet of disgustingness. Just like a big swamp planet. It's the home place of Slimer. So many references to pop culture today. What is going on? Oh yes, of course, we can't leave yet until we see the whooshy whoosh go everywhere. That's the official term for the whooshy whoosh. Staff of life. I do like the whole, seeing like the circle go around the whole planet and it transform into a luscious green place. It's beautiful, isn't it? It's actually really nice. I do like a good green planet. I know it's a bit generic. But out here in the depths of space where everything's black and cold, you've got to have some nice places. I suppose we could just make like this the garden place. Like the garden solar system. Yeah, sure. Okay, well here you go. Seeing as we've got like endless charges on this, I don't really feel that bad about using it everywhere. I suppose, is this actually counting towards this? Probably would be a good idea to check this first. Terra Wrangler. Wrangler. Improve the terraforming score on a planet 5 times to earn this. Oh, I see. So maybe we need to do it manually, not with this overpowered thing. Well, we'll see, won't we? Because this one's going to be improved. One. Okay, that didn't get us a badge. It's now going to go into terraforming score 2. No? Okay, I don't think this is actually counting, unfortunately. Let's just double check. No. Right. Okay. So we have got one of these though. So if we use the refrigeration ray, perhaps this will count. Yeah, it does. Okay. Well, at least we can buy these tools then instead. Expand Void Corporation. Wonderful. That's actually not helpful whatsoever. So what we'll do then is we'll seek out a load of 2 hot planets and start freezing them. Alternatively, we could just go to another nation and buy some more of those tools that just drains our energy instead. At least we're working towards something, right? Okay, so let's do that. Where are these things? Is it... No, Cloud Accumulator Heat Ray. Bit expensive, don't even care though. Okay, we'll go for that. We've got the laser. Do we even have... I swear to God we've already got the laser. Oh, we don't. Okay, we'll get the laser as well. Goodbye! Okay then! In fact, we can go to this planet here. Oh no, it's a gas giant. We can't go in here. I'd like some more interactions with gas giants as well. Maybe like in Stellaris where you mine them for power. Ooh, Planet Volptax is having an eco-disaster. Very useful. Oh, a powerful xenodepth mythic. A recent study of our wildlife returns some alarming data. The ecosystem on Planet Volptax is at great risk. A virus is spreading through some of our... Wow, really? I just noticed this. Through? What is this? The year 2000? Are we texting on your bloody Razer Samsung? We need to cull the infected from the pack immediately, or the virus will spread and we'll lose the entire species. And that may be the beginning of an entire biosphere collapse. We request your assistance, stat. Initiate the most effective, efficient flight plan at once. Okay, well, I'm going to come straight here. Not like that, naughty. What is going on? Oh, it's just this warning again. Fine. Volptax, I hope you have a good enough reason, a good enough reward for me saving your... sweet ass, again. Because my god, I'm not going to carry on doing this, my friends. Where are they? Down here? Oh yes, here's the smelly bastard. Oh, poor thing, it was like a llama. The stinky llama. That's what I would call a pub. If I ever opened a pub, it'd be called the stinky llama. I feel like that would probably attract a lot more people than you'd imagine. People love llamas, right? I think that's what I'd base my whole business plan on. Just selling... llama-based pun drinks. I feel like that's probably a good idea. That's my calling. I'd call it, like, the, Llamanade. Oh, God. Okay. All-powerful Xenodev the Mythic. You've been a great help today. Thank you for all your efforts here. Anytime. May I please sell all of my shit to you? Thank you so much. No cash reward. Cash money. Oh, dear God. You're so horrible to me. Okay, well, we'll buy one of these. And can we get any... We might as well just buy these as well. Have we got anything else here that we can sell them? It doesn't really look like it. But that's okay. I don't really want any of your rubbish. Dear God, man. What are you doing? I hate how these things, like, spaz out. The little, the paths of the spaceships when you zoom in and out of places. They've always done that. It's very Spore, isn't it? There's certain things about this game which I'll always think of being very Spore-like. And that is one of them. Most of them, sadly, are very glitchy things. But that's okay as well. Glitching in older games and those sort of little bugs, you used to play games for the fun of it. You didn't care about, you know, what the graphics looked like. How you doing, Jig Dog Empire? Or like all these little bugs. It added to the fun of it. It's like Skate 3, how glitchy that is. They did it on purpose, man. It's because they know that people love it. Ancient scriptures. What does it do? Could this be part of the lost scrolls of faith? I'm sure it isn't, but I'll buy it anyway. Okay, and we'll get this. And what is the last thing we need? Happiness booster. Do we not have one of those already? I don't think so. I swear to God, I'm just like buying everything right now. I don't even care. I just want to empty the shop. I want to buy everything in the game. I mean, yeah, sure, you can get to the end of the little progress bar here, but that doesn't mean jack shit, okay? You can take your progress bar and shove it right up your ass. Ah, maybe not that extreme, but you get my gist. I like to finish the game in its entirety, by literally buying everything you possibly buy, which doesn't even really make sense. But we're going to use the refrigeration ray, because I want to get that badge so we can buy a thing. I can't even remember what it was, because I have the short-term memory of a goldfish. Or a llama. Do llamas have particularly long short-term memories? That'd be kind of ironic, wouldn't it? Long short-term memories? Doesn't even make sense. That's why they love the llama pub. You'd go to the llama. Who here would go to a llama pub? I would go to a llama pub. Maybe we could like make all of the seats into the shape of a llama. And you can sit in the lap of a llama for an hour whilst you drink llamanade. I love this idea so much, I might do it. And everything, literally, even the urinals, you pee into a llama's mouth. I mean, what else could you want, really? Probably not much else. Okay, unfortunately this ecosystem is going to collapse because we're doing it the traditional way. But I don't really think it matters, because if I now just use the Staff of Life, it'll probably stabilise everything. Okay, so how is this working? 7 out of 10. Okay, so this is working. Unfortunately, it's going to be a bit of a drag, quite literally, because it means that we have to drag ourselves right back to our home planet. But I suppose that's okay. Just for the recharging. Dear God, man. Okay, well, that's probably going to be fine now. I always just wonder, like, what colour would planets out there be? Because the only reason that we got green things is because of the certain wavelength of the light that reaches the Earth and gets diffracted through the atmosphere. It's green, right? So it's green to absorb light or something. This is like the most inaccurate science lesson you'll ever have, so don't take this for red, for God's sake. But yeah, I wonder, like, on some planets, it'd be completely possible, right, to have, like, purple plants like this, surely? Or, like, red grass. I remember some episodes of Stargate. Man, I'm such a Stargate fan. I've watched all of SG-1 recently. It's such a good time, honestly. And I remember a lot of episodes on there, pretty much all the planets they go to look like what they've done in reality of just going to some forest in, like, Georgia or something and just filmed, like, some alien set out there. Oh, look, a planet sculpting tool. How lovely. Or it's a colouring tool, actually, isn't it? No, it is a sculpting tool. Okay, Crystal Mountains. Wow, that sounds pretty cool. Oh, holy shit, they're massive. Oh my god, oh my god. Wow, at least it does something. I wonder if we can make this any taller. I like playing around with stupid things like this. Okay, yes, but in Stargate, there's this one planet. Maybe it was in... Was it in Stargate Universe? It might have been. When they're on a planet and it was like there was red grass everywhere. That was really cool. That one sticks out in my mind for some reason. Because I'm a massive nerd, probably.